guys, good evening. How is everybody? Whew. Now, these guys up here have been working their tails off. I know they're already stressed. So if you will help me help them, on the count of three, we're all just going to take a real big, deep breath and then blow it out. We'll start. So, breathe in. And then, just going to have a little fun. Is that all right, guys? Well, okay, man. All right, good deal. Hey, guys. My name is Israel Lewis, and on behalf of Shandwick's Church, it is such a joy to have you on our campus here this evening. There's big, and then there's Mount Everest big. And for this ballhead guy, tonight is Mount Everest big because of the magnitude of what's happening. I believe our lives are like a book. And just like we have seasons, and we're in the middle of a changing season right now, we have these defining chapters in our lives. And with every bone in my body, I believe not just one, not just two, but many of these guys are going to go on to become some incredible musicians. And I believe when a friend or a teacher or a fan asks some questions like, where did it all start? Well, tell me how it all began. I believe the first name they're going to say is Susanna. And it all started way back in a little town you probably never heard of, in a little big church I know you've never heard of. And my parents came, and my friends came, and I fell in love with music. That's Mount Everest stuff to me. We got a couple of introductions. You know, we're not quite into the ceremony. We're supposed to be all formal. But I know you guys like being on TV. Okay, so if I say hi, Mom, we got some live TV behind the staff. So, Doug, thank you for being here. David Cage runs security back there. If you guys need anything whatsoever, if you've come in late out these doors and to the left are your restrooms. I can introduce Clay Harrison. If you'll wave to us, Clay. Clay is running for judge. And many of you that live in this community are certainly interested in our community, so please make sure and meet Mr. Harrison. He's our assistant district attorney right now, working for Will Ramsey. But the lady that I have been praying the hardest for the past couple of weeks is who I want to try and introduce now, who really needs no introduction to the most of you, but it was really fun when a couple of guys walked in and said, so kind of, what's this all about? And I said, I'm not sure I can really put it into words. To try to describe the heart of this director would be very, very difficult. One of the first things that I heard that was most impressive was it's incredible how she can hear every different instrument, all right, at the exact same time, and with the love of a mother or a grandmother, not go crazy, okay? We just kind of get a little wink, a little, hi, quit that please before I, you know. So I've been praying for the patience, I've been praying for her love. In fact, before we go any farther, can we just thank God that we get to be here tonight? Thanking God for the hours that Susanna has put into the lives of these precious kids. And then thanking God in advance for what's going to come. Not tomorrow, maybe not next month, but I really believe that, guys. I think something really special will start here tonight. If you're unaware, this is the very first performance of this orchestra. That's pretty incredible. We use some big words like inaugural, all right? I can't even spell it, okay? But here's what that tells me, all right? You get to experience history being made. And I know sometimes we love to use some big exaggerations, and okay? But when we realize that this is where it all began, with these guys up here, I am honored that I get to be here tonight. Would you pray with me, please? God, thank you for letting us be here. Thank you for these young people up on the stage that we are so, so proud of. God, thank you so much for Susanna, for her heart, for a willing desire to see a need, to realize that there was a community where there were children that wanted desperately to play, and had nowhere to play. God, thank you for this campus and for the ability for us just to join here together and to almost begin celebrating the holiday season a little early. with the joy of music, the joy of life, and the greatest joy of young people finding their passion. So God, thank you for all you've done. Jesus, thank you for making it possible. So in your name we pray. And the church said,
amen.
Let's give it up for Susanna, please.
Streams, and we have worked for about 3 months for these particular songs that we're playing tonight. And not only have they worked for just 3 months on this, they've worked years in private lessons, you know, parents, you know, supporting their kids, being able to take lessons in their school orchestra. You know, this is because they've spent hours in the previous years to get to this point. So this is nothing to do with me. I'm just a leader. I growl at the kids sometimes. but we are super excited and a wee bit nervous, especially me. I'm not sure if I'm more nervous than they are. These kids, they have not only been playing at least a year, some more, some less, and they have also, most of them haven't played in an orchestra before, much less in a group. So this is a big, you know, first event. And I'm sure you're going to hear a little, you know, they're kids, they're little uh-ohs here and there, but that's what you call learning. You know, we've got to make mistakes to be able to learn. And they're kids, and I'm super proud of what they are doing and what they have done to be able to be up here tonight. We're going to introduce the songs that we're playing. We're going to start with Beethoven's Ode to Joy. It is not your average Ode to Joy. It is an arrangement from our Violin 1 section has the melody. And so our Violin 2 sections has a harmony. We have a melody and counter harmony over here, but then they bounce that melody back and forth. Each section gets a part of the harmony, each section gets a part of the melody, which is very hard to do. they haven't played harmony, most of them, before, so it's definitely something, it takes years to kind of learn to do that. But they have done fabulous in just 3 months with this. So we are going to do that one. The next one is the John Dunbar theme from Dancing with the Wolves, and it's a beautiful arrangement, kind of dreamy and whimsical. Just don't fall asleep, it's a little too dreamy. Then our funnest one and the hardest piece we have is Soldier Joy. It is a fiddle arrangement. The kids kind of griped a bit at the beginning because it's too hard. I'm like, no, we're going to do it. We're going to learn it. And they have. They definitely have. You'll see a couple rock back and forth, I'm sure, getting into the music. But the fiddle arrangement, we have our bass boss, is what we call her. She's the queen of the orchestra, Kiara Young. She is actually our foundation, our beat. So you're going to hear her very strong in here, and she's going to be able to plug that first beat and counter back and forth. And very intricate and very hard to do. So we could not, our foundation, our queen. So you're going to hear different counterparts. There's different, we have melodies, harmonies, and a rhythm. I call it my Suzuki method teaching is hamburger, hamburger. You're going to hear the eighth notes and 16th notes kind of going back and forth underneath just to give it a little spice. So well, I hope you enjoy all the music. We're going to get started. been wonderful. That's the best I've heard it. I'm so singing proud of y'all. This being our first concert, again, these kids haven't played in a group like this, and as a teacher, it's a lot of work. Our first month practicing this music, especially Soldier's Joy, we had some grumblings. I growled a little at the kids again, but we got through it. We had to do individual parts, learning them, memorizing them, having chair tests, and they rose to the occasion and rocked it. Awesome. We are actually going to have a quick intermission so we can switch out our middle school orchestra with our high school. So if you need to go get your dress really quick, grab a cup of coffee, that's great. We'll be back in about 5 to 10 minutes, so see you soon. We are still growing. Of course, this is our first concert, and I have big dreams. I think we are capable of growing up to 100 kids. In between the orchestras. Between Greenville, we have several strings teachers in the area, as well as our school orchestra, who are doing awesome. We have the full capability of growing. And again, the youth orchestra is not just an additive. This is here to help support and back our strings program in Greenville and Sulphur Springs, and actually grow something here in Sulphur Springs that's going to more educate them. And it's more of a classical string. I'm a little nervous. I gotta breathe. So this is definitely something new for the kids. There's a couple of them that have not been in orchestra yet before, and some of them not full in high school yet. We do have a seventh grader in the high school group. Hey, Jonathan. And they've done really well, I feel. They've risen to the occasion. I told them this semester is just seeing where they are musically, and next semester I might blow their socks off, because we've got some Vivaldi, we've got some fun stuff coming up, even a possible soloist, they get to audition, so with the orchestra backing, so there's a lot of things that are coming in the future, and we can't do this without our audience, our community, so it's very important to have you here. Have you support us so we can grow. We can't do this without you. We are going to go ahead and start. We have On Die Music from Franz Schubert. We are going, Franz, this song is just a little bit of a classy feel. We're just giving you a little taste of what we have. Just kind of ease you into it. Then we're going to go into Chamber Suite in D from Handel. We're going from Adagio to Allegro. And if you're musically inclined, Adagio means slow. It's beautiful. Just kind of something you could fall asleep to. And then we jump into Allegro, and that might wake you up. Don't scream. We might tend to rush things with Allegro, so I might be running to keep up with them. But that song is definitely a classical. You've got a lot of structure and harmonies in there, and it's a lot of fun. It's a beautiful piece, a little bit difficult in areas, but they've done beautifully with it. Allemande from Corelli is next, and that's just a classic. It's a beautiful piece. They rock it. It's too easy for them, honestly. That's why we're going crazy next semester. Then the next two pieces we have are more modern. That the kids chose the songs. I love classical music. I would love to play classical music all the time, but they felt they need a little more romantic and sauciness in their life. So The River Flows in You, it's actually from Yuruma. He's the composer, but it is transcribed into an orchestral song, and it's beautiful, very romantic. Something you want to hear at a wedding. You're gonna be singing this for the rest of the night, or a week, I guarantee you. The next one, The Theory of Everything, is from a movie. Yeah? Okay, it's from a movie. I thought it was a TV show. I'm so old now that... The Theory of Everything, supposedly is a movie. I haven't watched it. I'm probably going to will eventually. I need to. Okay. So The Theory of Everything, it's got a little bit of a dark feel, And with a little magical, I call it fairy dust. You know, it's got some magic, some romantic, some breathtaking moments that you're just kind of, where am I? You know, second guesses you where, you know, where you're at. So that's their most fun piece. I think they like, but it's also the hardest. It's our more difficult one, but we're gonna have fun with it. So we're gonna go ahead and get started. I thought I heard a phone ringing behind me, so please turn off phones. I might have heard it. Could have been Jesus. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get started. Thank y'all.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
do a better job. They've really made beautiful music. They've shown love and joy through their music. I think you can feel it. I almost wish they could play at my wedding, you know, 4 years ago. if only. That was gorgeous. I'm super proud of y'all. Really, really, really proud. What you've seen tonight is a result of our community coming together financially, volunteering, and supporting us. There's several donors here tonight. There are several donors that aren't here tonight, and they made this concert possible. I'll be blunt with you. It costs about $1,500 to put this on, and that's a lot of money. When we're just starting out, that amount is small, considerably. There is, when we get bigger, it's going to cost a lot more, honestly. We can't do it without people sharing us with financially, sharing with us volunteering-wise, even spreading the word. If you have a business, putting the poster up on there, that goes a long way. I mean, it's crazy how many people in a small town will look on a window at my chiropractor office and be like, hey, what's that? That's new. I want to go. And that's huge. That helps a ton. That's what we consider our sponsors. That's what we consider people who have made this possible. A little nervous. A little bit about myself. I grew up, I wasn't the best child. My mom can attest to that. I am what some people would have called a bebe kid. I got kicked out of school a couple times. Probably got whoopings every day. Didn't help. and I was just kind of struggling as a kid. I didn't know pretty much what life was about, what was worth, you know. And I know a lot of kids these days struggle with the same feeling. They don't know where to channel their emotions. And me personally, I'm not trying not to cry. Me personally, music literally saved my life. My violin teacher's here tonight. Hey, he's great, Russell Lewis. I would not be here tonight if it weren't for you, if it weren't for my parents supporting me in my dream. I started the youth orchestra when I was about 13 or 14. And it sparked something in me. It sparked hope. It sparked healing. It sparked joy. It gave me a purpose in life. And I saw, you know, hey, I can be something. I am worth something. You know, if somebody doesn't like me, it doesn't matter. Music is it. This is healing for me. You know, and I want to make sure we have a facility that supports kids and shows them that, hey, you have a chance at life. Even if you're not going to be a professional musician one day, it doesn't matter. You are building life skills. You're building proper character, hard work, ethics. You're building passion and compassion for people, for music, for life in general. And this is where it starts. I mean, these kids have probably more work ethic than some adults out there do. And it's because of the parents investing in them, providing private lessons, providing them with an organization like this. And we couldn't do it without the parents, without our donors, our sponsors. So we are asking you to become a part of our family. We are a musical family. We are inviting our community to come in, be a part of us. We can't do it without you. You are our backbone. You are we're the heart for the music, but you are our whole venue, okay? Again, this would not be possible without you, especially for our first concert. Y'all get to see where we're starting now. Wait until you see next year. It's going to get cray-cray. we're going to grow. And even if I have to go and teach about 50 kids for free, we're going to do it. We're going to get them. We are here to give back to our community. That is our sole purpose. Learning to love ourselves, learning to love the music through the arts, learning the classical string art, that's the proper word. And we want to give back. We want to be a part. So as a nonprofit organization, 501c3, any donations that you give, it's tax deductible. You know, as long as it's, I think, if you want a receipt, if it's under 100, we can definitely do that. Anything over 100 automatically gets mailed a receipt. We have a donation box in the back, and Our treasurer, Rebecca Taylor, is back there. She can answer any questions if you have some. Also, we have t-shirts for sale, which is fun. Everybody needs t-shirts. If we don't have your size, let us know and we can order some. We have our board of directors and our board members, which are all our parents, students' parents, and they have provided the whole reception. Where's Toby Washburn, right? They decorated the entire outside foyer. They're fabulous. I mean, I couldn't have done that. If I had to do it, you know, on top of everything else. But people like Toby, people like our parents that are supporting us, make this whole organization possible as well. This concert is put on by our parents. And so we thank them, we thank our kids for working hard and being awesome. I love them very much. Our concert master. I'm a little excited. Go ahead and stand up, Michaela. He's our boss. We have singing auditions, and every kid, we have certain sections, like the first violin section, we have a portion of music that they learn, and then we have private auditions to where anybody in the section could get first chair if you work hard enough. And so Michaela has stepped up, doesn't belittle anybody else, because they sure as hell stepped up as well. It's pretty awesome. I'm very proud of y'all. Thank you for making this possible. Thank y'all for coming out tonight, and we look forward to the future. One last thing I forgot. I keep forgetting things. Hi. Those are pretty.
Hey, our heart is full tonight. It was full of music and full of love for all these talented kids. And I'm thankful that we found Miss Susanna. And actually, our family found her on the yard sale page. One of my girls had been wanting to practice violin and learn it, and we looked for a year for a teacher. And someone had an instrument for sale on the yard sale page, and we found out we had a teacher, not just a teacher, but a fabulous teacher just 20 minutes away. And our hearts are full for her tonight. And she did. You have to be careful who you let influence your kids. And we don't have no problem with Susanna at all. Well, she does tell some stories. we're so thankful for her. And I know my kids love the music. They love her. She's become part of our family. And I know one of my girls says when they grow up, they want to teach violin like Miss Susanna. And on behalf of all the parents, we just want to say thank you and that we love you.
Thank you so much for coming.
you think?
I think the kids did fabulous. They have stepped up way more than I could have expected. They have taken the challenge and learned and actually made beautiful music, shown love to our community by giving back, but also learning to love themselves through the music. You know, they've really done fabulous with it, especially the little kids. Where did they come from? They're fabulous. I keep using that word. They're awesome, though. We look forward to what's coming in the future. I think this next semester is going to be a lot of fun. The little kids don't know it yet, but we're doing a movie theme. So Beauty and the Beast. We're doing Star Wars. We're doing Pirates of the Caribbean. That's the middle school. And they get to dress up. They're going to freak out when they hear it. The high school, we're going to do some definitely more Vivaldi and a lot more possible solo violinists coming in through with the orchestra backing. So that's going to be a highlight of our next concert. Definitely looking forward to what the future holds. And again, we can't do this without our community, without our community support, because we are a community orchestra, a nonprofit 100%. We're called the Sulphur Springs Youth Orchestra for a reason. We are Sulphur Springs. So thank you so much for joining.
Where do these kids come from? These are your private students?
Not all of them. I probably teach about, I think, 18 out of the entire group, out of 25 kids. And there's other teachers. There's a couple in Greenville that have brought in their own students, and it's been wonderful. I would love more. I'm not here to take students away from teachers. And we're building the music in our community, in our counties, pretty much, to be able to give back and build everybody together musically. So I did not teach everybody.
Okay, well, the last time I talked to you, you were a strings teacher. How did all of this happen?
Well, in May, I had a friend approached me, and she's like, "Hey, what do you think about a youth orchestra?" And I'm like, "Well, it's been a dream of mine. I didn't expect to do it, probably for a few years." And we had some things happen in our strings program at schools that we're like, "Oh, we gotta, you know, build up. We want to keep as many kids as we want in that strings orchestra, and make sure that we're having extra work for our kids to learn with." And so I'm like, okay, let's just go ahead and start it. So we started in September officially. We are 501c3, 100%. So starting, this is just the beginning. We only have 25 kids, but my goal is 100. We're fully capable of it, so.